Hey guys, Tyreka back. Now I'm going to do my MGM Beasts collection. And this was requested by a user, but I forgot the user's name. I apologize for that. Otherwise, I would have already mentioned it. Anyways, I do apologize for that, though, but I am doing my MGM VHS collection. So I am doing the request. I just don't remember the user's name, so I do apologize for that. I do have two Skype guests, Tom Productions and Davini Troy. Let's get started. The clamshells. Again, I'm kind of getting bored with counting them, so, you know, I'm not even going to count them anymore. I'm kind of getting tired of it. So anyways, let's get started. First, I got High Society. It's fine. Here's the back. MGM UA on video, right there. Tape. And label. I tape back on because there's no print date on this tape underneath the end label. There's no print date. Next, I got The Wizard of Oz. 1985 VHS. There it is. Print date. November 4th, 1985. And this tape does not have the black screen of death at the end. It has nothing at the end. Next, I got the 1986 VHS of Gigi. And print date is December 24th, 1986. This date does use the black screen of death at the end. It's pretty cool to print on Christmas Eve. Next, I got That's Entertainment Part 2. Also in a black clamshell. However, this is a reprint, so it does not have that MGM UA Home Video logo right there. And it also does not have an end label either. No print date. And this tape, unfortunately, does not have the black screen adapt at the end. I was expecting this to have the black screen adapt. It does not have it, sadly. Next, I got 1990 VHS of MGM's Greatest Moments. Lucky, my copy does not have the black screen adapt and has no print date on it. It's the 1990 print. Next, I got The Wizard of Oz from 1996. THX digitally mastered, excuse me. Label's missing. June 13, 1996. So this tape's anniversary is today. Next, I got All Dogs Go to Heaven, part MGM Family Entertainment. And guys, sorry if you're in the background, because it's actually thunderstorming in my area right now. So just ignore the thunder if you hear it. No print date. For some odd reason. No print date. It's pretty weird. For MGM tape. Oh, that was a bad one. Next, I got The Princess Bride, MGM Family Entertainment. It's fine. Here's the back. Tape. December 7, 1998. Yes, it does have the Fox logo at the end, I know. It's pretty cool. Chitty Chitty Bang Bang, part of MGM Family Entertainment. It's mine. Here's the back. Ink label. August 17, 1999. Next, I got two copies of The Black Stallion. Start this copy. Clebble. Apparently, you're starting with the better copy. January 23rd, 2001. Here's this copy. December 28th, 2002. This one is pretty jumpy. I'm still going to keep both copies, though, believe it or not. Next, I got Napoleon, part of MGM Family Entertainment. It's fine. He's back. Last clamshell before we get to the cut boxes and the big boxes. March 14th, 2001. So, 2 months before I was born. And now let's get to the two cut boxes. The final option. This is actually a bootleg. I'm still keeping this tape because it's a very rare, very early 1980s MGM tape. Very rare bootleg, and surprisingly, it is a former rental, despite being a bootleg, and having 30 minutes of blue screen of death at the end. Full Martial from Mongo Video. I don't even think they realized it was a bootleg or anything back in the day. For proof, I even did the closing to it, if you want to see it. I talked VH Solving Software Teen Channel. Next, I got Camille. That. And there's actually no back on this one. Unlike one of my other VHS tapes, Shane. It actually had the back, like, in here, but this one does not even have the back, period. That's pretty weird. February 9th, 1987, and this tape has the black screen of death at the end. Next, I got 2001 A Space Odyssey, MGM CBS Video. Very, very rare tape from 1980, I believe. I could be wrong, though. And this film's from 1968, I believe, according to the label. And this tape does use the 1968 MGM logo at the beginning. And there is no print date on this tape. This tape does have a couple previews at the end. Like, I believe a preview for Wizard of Oz, I think? I don't remember exactly. I'll have to look at the ending again. Yes, it does. Okay. Next, I got the Snotty Kid. Another big box for you guys. I also have one other big box after this. So I have three MGM big box tapes. No print date. No end label either. It's pretty weird. MGM Home Video in there. Pretty cool. Also got Dream Lover. Another big box. Pretty cool. Even though the big box is in pretty terrible condition. It's falling apart and everything. I'm still going to keep this tape, though. Print date is December 9th, 1986. This tape used the black screen of death and only for 15 seconds. Pretty short. MGM Home Video right there. And very, very old looking reels. Next I got Gone with the Wind Deluxe Edition from 1996. Pretty rare. I know Duncan Burden also has the exact same box set I have. Even though he got it way before me, I decided to show it anyway. Just for the fun of it. Plus, it's an MGM tape. I got this tape on March 19th, 2016, I believe. If I remember the date correctly. Oh, I did? Okay. Remembered correctly. December 19th, 1996 for part 1. And part 2 is December 18th, 1996, the day before part 1. Pretty weird. Part 2 is actually a little bit older than part 1. Pretty weird. I also have a James Bond box set, which I'm just going to get over with already. Because this is a really big box set. I'm just going to get over it already. You know, just show it already. Very early. To get it over with. Here's Goldfinger. Clevel. November 23rd, 1999. Thunderball. November 23rd, 1999, same print date. November 22nd, 1999, day before. Never let die. November 22nd, 1999, same print date. A lot of these have duplicated print dates. November 24th, 1999. This one. Wow, November 23rd, 1999 also. And this one. April 14th, 2000. So yeah, that's the huge seven tape James Bond box set I have. So now let's get to the regular slipcovers now, and two tape sets, you know, just normal ones. Next I got Dark Victory. I think this is one of the oldest slipcovers I have. Sticker label. No print date on this tape. Some of the early ones have no print dates. This next one also has no print date. The original copy of Ben-Hur. I also have a 1993 reprint, which I'll show after this. Part 1 and Part 2. I actually was originally ordering the MGM CBS video tape of this, but I got the wrong tape. I got this instead. I'm still going to keep it anyway. Because it's still pretty cool. And plus, I only paid like around $5 for it. It wasn't really that much, so, you know. I'm still going to keep it anyway. No print date on either tape. This one, these ones do have print dates. This is the 1993 reissues. I have updated labels and everything, even though I've had this one for a longer time. Both tapes are February 18, 1993. Next, I got For Your Eyes Only, the Moore Collection. Two print dates and a day and year code. July 18, 1988, May 20th, 1988, and 20th day, 1988, which January 20th, 1988, obviously. Pretty cool. Next. And by the way, that tape does use the black screen adaptation before I forget to say that. Next, I got Sing in the Rain MGM Musicals. This also uses the black screen adaptation. August 24th, 1988. Hold on! Sorry, my parents were calling me. 2001 Space Odyssey. January 18, 1989, January 5th, 1989. Black Train of Death, that one as well. One of the last ones of the Black Train of Death. And same with this next one. Philadelphia Story. Another one of the last with Black Train of Death at the end. February 7, 1989, February 6, 1989, so it did part. Tom and Jerry's 50th Birthday Classics. Yes, this even has the first episode ever made on this tape from Tom and Jerry, I believe, right? Yes, this tape actually has the very first Tom and Jerry episode ever made. It's the first episode in this tape, I think. Dog Trouble. Yes, it does have that. Along with Puss Gets the Boot, Catfishing. A Mouse in the House. Yeah, you do a mouse. Heavily Puss and Part Time Pal. Those are the episodes on this tape. March 7, 1990. Next, two copies of Vlogs are having. Let's start the extremely rare demo tape. I got from eBay. Okay. May 1st, 1990 on a label instead of being printed. That's pretty cool. And here's the regular copy. August 13th, 1990. It's starting to fade out, but I can still read it. I hope to get a copy with the barcode sometime soon. That is a week and year code. I think Brandon Movie Guy is a copy of the week and year code. Hope to get a copy like that soon in the future if I ever find it at my art thrift store. Next, I got Of Mice and Men demo tape. I'm in the middle of a video, Mom. What's going on? Tape. This is Academy screening cassette. December 13, 1992. Sorry, didn't see that one there at first. December 13, 1992, so 12 days before Christmas. Hold on, guys. Okay, sorry about that. Oh, guys! I forgot something. There's a Paramount tape I forgot to show in my Paramount VHS collection. I need to get to that really quick. I'm so sorry, guys. I forgot all about it. Here it is. Sleepy Hollow Paramount VHS Special Edition. I'm just showing it very, very fast. Apologize. 38 Figure 2000, and the barcode fell off. I could tell it's boring barcode. Yeah, that's the tape I forgot. Anyways, let's continue with my MGM tapes. I apologize. Quickly Down Under with Tom Selleck. January 6th, 1993. Next, I got The Unforgiven. June 8th, 1993. Alright. Next, I got Fistful of Dollars with Clint Eastwood. March 19th, 1994. Next, I got A Christmas Story from 1994. November 8th, 1994. You Only Live Twice. March 15th, 1995. Excuse me again. Next, I got Father of the Bride in Glorious Black and White. This tape does have the black and white previews at the beginning. I believe, same with Dark Victory, if I remember correctly. March 26th, 1995. Next, I got On Her Majesty's Secret Service. And the per date is April 13th, 1995. Next day, we got Thunder Road. This tape also has black and white previews. July 8th, 1995. The Great Escape. Two tapes set. Part 1, Part 2. Both tapes are printed on August 5th, 1995. Next tape I got, From Russia with Love. Print date is October 9th, 1995. Next tape I got, Thelma and Louise. Did the opening of this once, copyright, yep. September 11th, 1996. So 5 years before the terrible attacks that nobody wants to be reminded of. Next I got GoldenEye, part of the Deluxe Letterbox Edition. Tape, October 2nd, 1996. I have not popped it in yet, so I don't know if it has THX beginning or not. Flipper, part of the MGM UA Home Video Family Treasures. Vertical sticker label, sorry. October 31st, 1996, so printed on Halloween, 1996. That's pretty cool. Next, I got The Birdcage. Print date is February 7, 1997. This is a letterbox tape, just like GoldenEye, and both this and GoldenEye, if you didn't notice, has that letterbox box in there. It also has it on GoldenEye for proof. Let me go ahead and get that out really quick. See? See? Look at that letterbox thing. Has it as well. Pretty cool. Next I got Fiddler on the Roof, two tape set, part of the MGM UA Home Video Screen Epics. Part 1, and then Part 2. July 2nd, 1997, and July 1st, 1997, so Part 2, again, is a little... Wait. So Part 1, again, is a little bit older than Part 2. That's pretty weird. Next I got Meet Me in St. Louis. Tape. Per date is July 22nd, 1997. How to Get So Christmas. July 24th, 1997, so 2 days apart. So 2 days after Meet Me in St. Louis, which is pretty cool. Next I got Rain Man, part of the MGM Commentary Classics. Mine is November 11, 1997, so Veterans Day. Leaving Las Vegas. November 17, 1997. 6 days after Rain Man. And this one, believe it or not, this was the day after. November 18, 1997. Pretty cool. Next I got City Slickers, part of MGM UA Movie Time tape. December 19, 1997. So, 6 days before Christmas. The guys, again, ignore the background. It's thundering a lot outside right now. We're under a severe thunderstorm warning. Sorry about that. Next, got Man in the Iron Mask. And sorry to get off topic yet again. I didn't mean to, but, yeah. Anyways, let's just keep going. November 23rd, 1998. Month, 2 days for 2 days before Christmas. Gone with the Wind. Now we're going to MGM Home Entertainment and slipcovers. Part 1 is December 15, 1998. Part 2 is December 16, 1998. So, the day apart. Next I got Stemata. Wow, I'm even worse at pronouncing it than I was yesterday. Not yesterday, Saturday, excuse me. Sorry about that. And this is actually a Canadian copy. My only Canadian MGM tape. Hopefully you'll get more soon. January 27, 2000. Mm-hmm. Lucky, I only have a single one. I know you have three of them. I only have a single one. Oh, you have five of them. I thought you said three. Sorry. You have five of them. Wow. Next, I got Autumn in New York. Whoops. Purchased with Blockbuster on March 5th, 2001. Clibble. Per date is ruined. Just like Divinity's copy. Next, Spaceballs, part of MGM Movie Time tape. I know Divinity wants to tape so badly. I hope to get that tape sometime soon, the 1988 print of this. And, I'm still gonna keep this copy, though, if I do. March 9, 2000. Next, I got another copy of The World's Not Enough. I now have two copies of this tape. I'm keeping both copies. This one is earlier, March 13, 2000. 4 days after. It's Spaceballs. Mm-hmm. Silence of the Lambs. Clayable. February 1st, 2001. So, pretty early copy. Next, I got The Claim. Got this on Saturday. Okay. Full more rental from Family Video. May 14th, 2001. The day I was born. This tape was printed on. That's pretty cool. Jeepers Creepers. Purchase a Blockbuster on something something 2002. November 6, 2001. Next, I got two copies of GoldenEye. Start this copy. Okay, well. December 19th, 2001. Here's this copy. This one is August 16th, 2001, so this one's earlier. And now we're on, we only have seven more left. Next, I got Good Boy, 2004 VHS. January 24th, 2004. Now we're starting to get into the dark ink. What? Nice! My copy is the same print as your copy. Nice. Next, I got Virginia's Run. That. This film's actually from 2002, but this is a really late 2005 reprint. January 30th, 2005. Next, I got Soul Plane. Yeah. Hope to get the unrated version of VHS as well. I'm still going to keep both copies. February 18th, 2005. Walking Tall. The Rock. Mine is May 10th, 2005. And this next one, and these last three are not distributed by MGM. I showed you guys all the tapes I have distributed by MGM. Now, the last three are, two of them are Sony tapes, are distributed by Sony instead, but they're still MGM films, so they're still included. And there's one Paramount demo tape that we'll get to. That's also an MGM film, so just go ahead and include it again. But start the one of the Sonys, the Amityville Horror. See, this is actually really an MGM tape, but it's distributed by Sony instead of MGM. And those nowhere to be, Sony logo's nowhere to be seen on the case at all. Look at that. Nowhere to be seen at all. It looks like pretty much, it look like an MGM tape, but look, it's actually a Sony tape. And it does have the Sony logo at the beginning of everything. And it's Sony previews. September 2nd, 2005. This is still a Sony tape, though. I mean, MGM tape, though. Yep. The demo tape of Yours, Mine, and Ours. And y'all showed it previously. I'm just going to show it again. It's also a Columbia, MGM, Nickelodeon, and Paramount movie. All four logos are shown at the beginning. December 14th, 2005. Excuse me. Yep. And it's the 2006 VHS of Into the Blue. And this is distributed by Sony. Even though it actually has Sony on the back, even though because it's more of a Sony release, but it's also an MGM movie, so it's kind of included too. Clayable Blue Lid Black Reels, per date March 7, 2006. Hope you guys enjoyed this this video. Hope you guys enjoyed this my MGM VHS collection, and request more, and I will do more. So I will see you guys later.